Hello, everyone. It's great to be with you again this week. Kind of a gloomy type week, really cool, although we're supposed to be in temperatures by the end of the week that are seasonal. And yes, we do need some heat, don't we? So it's good to, as I say, to always be with you. And it sounds and looks like our lockdown is going to continue. So we just have to, I know everybody's getting anxious. I am certainly really getting anxious to get out and meet people. And a good thing is I was able to spend some time with my grandson, who's going to be 20 this year, which was nice to see him. So let us begin. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And a belated happy Mother's Day to all those mothers and grandmothers. You are so special, and we're so blessed to have you. And as we begin, we always thank our Lord, that He's present among us, and as we, offer our thoughts and prayers up to Him. And we always, start with a bit of a penitential rite in offering our wrongdoings up to Him. You were sent into the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. And you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. And we're still in the Easter season, although a couple of weeks we're approaching Pentecost Sunday. And that's what our readings are focusing on, throughout the next 2 weeks. This coming Sunday is Trinity Sunday, and that's when we acknowledge that the Trinity is part of the Father and the Son, three in one. And so, Lord, Almighty Father, the source of everlasting light, send forth your truth into our hearts and pour over us the brightness of your light. And I think this is what Jesus is saying to us, in our readings. And he's getting ready to depart, and we have to continue to know that he's present in the Spirit. So I got a hymn that many might be familiar with, Morning Has Broken.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Singing praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world. Sweet the rains new fall, sunlit from heaven. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning. Morning has broken like the first morning, blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from.
That's a beautiful hymn, isn't it? And I think that kind of reflects on the season we're in. It's, I know many of you might be watching this in the afternoon, you know, so this past morning, but the message is still there. And in our readings, as I say, that's what's reflected. And we hear from Jesus when he says to his disciples, "Now I am going to the one who sent me, and not one of you asked me, 'Where are you going?' But because I told you this, grief has fallen in your hearts." So we know what that feels like, you know, when we lose somebody we love, and especially during the funeral part and shortly after, you know, death goes. And I guess our subconscious, you know, we always say, sure, we pray and trust that they go to heaven. But here's Jesus saying to his disciples, you know, you're not even asking me where I'm going, but he tells them the truth. And it's better for you that I go. For if I do not go, the advocate will not come to you. And that's what we're, you know, talking about, the advocate. And of course, we know that's the Holy Spirit. And he continues to say, but if I go, I will send him to you. And of course, you know, it's not about our sins. It's about doing the right thing. And it's that we believe just not in him, but we believe in the righteousness. And because he's going to the Father, his Father, and the disciples weren't going to see him anymore. And that's where our faith really comes into play, because it's the Spirit, that the advocate, that fills us with his, you know, unending love. And it's hard to say goodbye to those we love. Just imagine, you know, the disciples were scared most of the time. We hear in Acts, our first readings, how, you know, St. Paul, this was certainly after, you know, Jesus had ascended, you know, that he was often put in jail and shackled, and the Holy Spirit would come upon them and release them, but they would not leave. They just stayed there. And in doing that, he evangelized, and the guards, you know, often converted to Catholicism, believing in, or not so much Catholicism, but Christianity, believing, you know, that Jesus is the Savior and the great counselor. He's the sweet guest of our souls, you know, the Holy Spirit. So that's what we cling on. We call upon that when we were baptized. We acknowledged it again when we made our confirmation. And we really need to rely on the gifts, the fruits that come from the Holy Spirit. You know, I've said it before, God never gives us anything more than we can handle. And even during, you know, these hard times of COVID and not being able to see those we love and touch and hug, you know, he's helping us get through it. And that's, you know, of course, what he was saying to the disciples. And he also, you know, our faith tells us that the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit abide in us. While our eyes may not see it, we may not hear it, but we're never alone. And especially, you know, in the when we're grieving and having a hard time. So just let's ask the Lord to increase our faith, increase our hope, and increase our love. Help us to be alert, sober in a sense when it comes to our faith, and open our hearts to receive and enlighten the gifts and the fruits, you know, that we heard in that hymn. So Lord, today by the grace we will list the gifts and fruits of the Holy Spirit and strive to be more concretely and make proper use of them. So as we continue, you know, let's just listen to another hymn. And I think, you know, because we're approaching Trinity Sunday and then the end of the month is Pentecost, and then we go into Pentecost season. But it's about receiving the Holy Spirit. So I've got a hymn here, Come Holy Spirit. Isn't that beautiful? And that's about what we're celebrating now is the Holy Spirit. And I think let's do our community prayer. Just move that up for everybody. Loving God, you will fill all things with the fullness of hope that we can never comprehend. Thank you for leading us into time where more of reality is being unveiled for us all to see. We pray that you will take away our natural temptations of cynicism, denial, fear, and despair. Help us to have the courage to awaken the greater truth, greater humanity, and greater care for one another. May we place our hope in what matters and what's last, trusting in your eternal presence and love. Listen to our hearts, longing for the healing of our suffering world. Please, this is the time if you have a special intention. And I think let's offer up prayers to our moms and all those that have such an influence on our lives. Knowing, good God, you are healing us better than we are speaking. We offer these prayers in your holy name of God. Amen. And as we continue with our reflection today, let's just be mindful that the Lord has been lifted up above the earth and will draw all things to himself. So let us cry out to him in our joy as we ask him, Lord Jesus, you are the King of glory. And with that comes a commitment to continuing to be open to his love. Eternal priests and ministers of the new covenant, you live for the ever to make intercessions for us. Save us as we pray to you. Today you promise the Spirit, as you promised it to the apostles, you promised to us. And so we make it as our witness to the ends of the earth. By the power of the Spirit, strengthen our witness to you. And in that, we also pray for all those we love and we can't be near. I know on Mother's Day, I have a son in BC, a son in Alberta, a son in Nova Scotia, and a daughter here in Midland, us in Midland. So we are trying to coordinate a Zoom with all the different time chains. And we did get connected. Kids, it doesn't matter how old they are, they still sometimes drive you crazy. We got to see our grandson in BC, Charlie. He's going to be 7. And our granddaughter in Edmonton, Alberta, she's 16. And then we have a grandson here that I mentioned earlier. He's going to be 20 in June. Wow, time ever go. And then it's always great to, them to see their mom and we get to talk. So as we come to our time that, although we can't receive communion, it doesn't look anytime soon that things are going to open up. They're talking about extending it now on into June. So we, know that we believe in the presence of the Blessed Sacrament. And although, it's the true substance, that's our Catholic belief, and we cannot receive communion in the fashion that we would like to, but we know that he comes spiritually into our hearts. And we know that he's always with us and he embraces us. And we unite ourselves wholly to him in his name. Amen. So let's have another hymn. And everybody's favorite, Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now
That's a nice form of Amazing Grace, isn't it? It's a little different, but the animation there kind of tells the story about our lives too, eh? And so as we come to a conclusion, getting over my time here, but I'll leave with the final blessing, and just know that you're in our thoughts, you're in our prayers, and we have to just soldier on. We will get through this. There certainly is a feeling of as more people are getting vaccinated, and I expect many will start their second vaccination pretty quick, and we continue to pray for that. So the Lord be with you and with your spirit. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So go in peace, everyone, and my thoughts are with you. And we will close with a hymn that you can just listen to. And I think I've decided to follow Jesus, because this is what the Ascension is about, that we're coming up to, and then Pentecost Sunday, when the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, is given to us. God bless and be safe.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. The world behind before me, the world behind me, the cross before me, the world behind me, the cross before me, no turning back, no turning back, though